Hello everyone, it's Captain Sensible here with another quick review before Mr. Smelly does his video. So today we're going to be having a look at Valentino Uomo Intense by Versace. The notes on this one are iris, cedarwood, cocoa pops and Adam's apples. And the perfumier was Jimmy Greaves. Now if I had to give this a mark out of 10, I'd give it a 9 out of 10, but I don't, so I won't. Now the other thing I wanted to talk about today, I'm going to answer some of my viewers' questions. So here we go. Sensational Steve has asked, how long does a bottle usually last you? Well, about an hour and a half if it's a normal whiskey, or maybe about an hour and three quarters if it's a single malt whiskey and I'm really savouring it. And with those, sometimes I'll even drink them with a glass. Now, the other one, the second and final one, Smelly Terry has asked, which of these two scenarios would you prefer? Either you have to have two cats sellotaped to your head for the rest of your life, or you have to break wind loudly after every third word that you speak for the rest of your life. Oh, that's a tough one. I'll leave it over to you. Let me know in the comments below, viewers, which one of those two you'd prefer. It's a toughie, isn't it? Alright, over to Mr. Smelly's video now.
Hello everyone, welcome back. So today we're going to be having a look at my top 10 designer fragrances for men for autumn 2018. Stay tuned to the channel in future because we're also going to be having a list on my top 5 really inexpensive great value fragrances. Some of the ones in that upcoming list could be considered designer fragrances too. Bentley, for example, makes some really good affordable fragrances. In this list, I'm focusing on houses which are your really classic, traditional, well-established designer fashion houses. Your Chanel's, your Dior's, Jean-Paul Gaultier, etc. That kind of thing. So let's find out which 10 I've picked. Let me know what you think of my choices. Of course, autumn time, things are getting colder. We're moving away from the really fresh scents of the summertime. And we're looking for things that are maybe a little bit more warming, things that have maybe more woodsy notes. An autumnal feel might mean that perhaps a little bit more sweetness will come in there, maybe notes like tobacco, that kind of thing. So things getting a little bit heavier and richer scent-wise as the weather gets a bit colder. So let me know what you think of the list. Let's get into it.
Okay, first up then, so this is position number 10, and it's Givenchy Gentleman Only Intense. This was a 2014 release. Notes are black pepper, mandarin, birch leaf, patchouli, cedarwood, leather, tonka bean, amber, and incense. It's a really nice, peppery, spicy, yet fresh and woody masculine scent. I find this one deserves a little bit more credit than it gets. I think the Givenchy line in general doesn't get a lot of talk in the fragrance community, certainly on YouTube. And, you know, if they do, then it's not really Givenchy Gentleman Only or any of its flankers that seem to get a lot of talk. But I really, really like this one. Claire from the Smurfy Girly channel is also a fan. It's peppery, spicy, fresh as well as woody. And there's a little bit of a darkness about it. But it combines that with a freshness and a really, really nice, crisp, autumnal kind of feel about this one. That's why I've put it in the autumn list. It's dark, but it's fresh at the same time. And I think it's a really good designer release. Next up, then, I'm going to go with something it's pretty different. This is Aramis, the original Aramis Eau de Toilette from 1965. A very masculine scent. Some of the notes include leather, musk and castoreum. There's bergamot in the top, there's cumin in there, clary sage, patchouli. It's heavy, it's masculine, certainly woody, but it's also leathery and musky. Sort of a little bit of a forerunner of things like Koros that came along in the 80s, or Chanel's and Taos. Very, very heavy masculine scent. There is freshness in there, and there is a delicacy, there are floral notes. It's a really, really traditional French-style perfume with lots of complex, different notes going on in there. There are some quite sensuous and soft and almost, not feminine, but, you know, much more floral and delicate notes in there, and this overwhelming masculinity. And it's a really, really great scent for the autumn. Totally overlooked, very inexpensive. Check out Aramis. Moving on then, Valentino Uomo Noir Absolute, something completely different, an oriental fragrance from 2017, flanker to the original Valentino Uomo. Great bottle there, look at that lovely plaque on it, and the design similar to Valentino Uomo Intense, which is getting a mention later in the video. Black pepper, cinnamon, incense, sandalwood, resinoid. It's sweet, dark, spicy, and exotic. There's a ton of cinnamon in there. If you like cinnamon, good. If you don't like it, avoid, because there's a really strong cinnamon note and this very exotic incense and sandalwood combination. I really enjoy this one and I find it a perfect autumnal scent. Performance is quite good on this one. By the way, Aramis, very strong in performance. Givenchy Gentleman Only Intense, just so, not the best performance, maybe a daytime scent. But this one, really, really spicy, exotic twist, and not the iris that you get in Valentino Uomo Intense. Next up then is Rive Gauche Pour Homme. This one goes right back to 2003 and kind of looks back further in time for its inspiration. This is the reissue in the La Collection series. The other bottle has a kind of a hairspray barbershop pole design. It smells a lot like a really nice shaving foam. We've all heard of this one. If you want something fresh for autumn but you don't want a really citrusy aquatic summery scent, this kind of barbershop shaving foam-esque smell with lavender, let's have a look at some of the notes. There's lavender, geranium, patchouli, vetiver, guaiac wood. It's woody, it's smooth, it's a little bit floral, it's got that lavender note that we associate with barbershop scents, some tonka bean probably going on. Not everything in the notes was listed on the bottle there. And a really, really great update, many people think, on Azzaro Pour Homme from 78, but made a little bit more smooth for the 21st century. Really love Rive Gauche for a fresh scent, like a work scent in the autumn time. Moving on then, Fahrenheit Parfum. What can we say about this? Fantastic update on the original Fahrenheit. Some of the notes in Fahrenheit Parfum: mandarin, violet, leather, and vanilla. There's also incense, I think, a little bit in there, and there's also some in some places listed a note of rum and even licorice. It takes the original Fahrenheit from 1988, known for its petroleum kind of smell, and this distinctive violet leaf note. The violet leaf's still in there, there's a hint of the petroleum, but things are smoothed out, much more sweet and a little bit more smooth, less rugged, but not less sophisticated. That's the key thing, it hasn't been dumbed down. There's incense in there, there is almost a little bit of a boozy feel and more sweetness, but it's a sophisticated sweetness. Francois Demachy, the master perfumer who brought us that one, and I really like that update on the original Fahrenheit. Next up then, it's Versace Man. I think this was in Carlos the Brooklyn Fragrance Lovers list as well. So I'm in good company there. Domitil Michelon, the perfumer for this one, and this was a 2003 release. Known as a tobacco scent, and there is certainly a lot of tobacco in there. There's also neroli, bergamot, cashmere, cardamom, and saffron. If you're looking for a really interesting, sophisticated, woody scent that can be had for great prices, I think Versace Man is an excellent choice. I think you can get this on Notino still in the UK for a really great price for a 100ml bottle. Lovely bottle design there as well. So it's a nice, dark, woody, almost reminds me of ebony wood. Not that that has a smell that you can extract, but if they kind of represented that by creating an accord using other notes, that's kind of been done here a bit. Definitely got some tobacco in it. Not much sweetness though, a dry tobacco woody scent. Next up then, a discontinued one for you, Gaultier Squared. I've tried to limit the number of discontinued scents. I'm going to do a top five or some kind of discontinued scent soon because I've got some new ones lately. But Gaultier Squared from Jean-Paul Gaultier. The only notes listed in this one, musk, vanilla and amber. It's a Francis Kirkjohn job here for the perfumer who did the original La Malle from this house in 1995. This one released in 2005. Very, very sweet. Definitely, I would say, a gourmand, officially an oriental fragrance. If you take Jean-Paul Gaultier's La Malle and add in a ton of vanilla, you sort of get this, but actually I think they've added in a little bit of orange blossom from the female release, Jean-Paul Gaultier's Classique, also from the mid-90s. Really, really nice, sweet scent. Some people will find it cloying, some people will find it synthetic. It could be all of those things. The amber colour there reminds me of autumn, and it smells great as an autumn scent if you want something a little bit more sweet, sexy, playful. I love Gaultier Squared. Hard to find now. Moving on, it's Dior Homme Intense versus the one we all compare it to, Valentino Walnut Intense. Both great iris-based scents. They both have this lipstick-esque iris note that shouldn't necessarily be what you would associate with a great men's perfume, but since Dior Homme did this first in 2005, we've all got used to the fact that iris can be a great note when it's done this way in fragrances. So the original Dior Homme Intense, lovely intensification of the original Dior Homme Eau de Toilette, a little bit of a cacao-esque chocolate thing going on there, maybe some smooth leather, a little bit of ambrette seed and or vanilla, and the Valentino Wilmore there with a great bottle design adds a little bit more sweetness to that, maybe more of a dark chocolate note going on there, a little bit more of the leather as well, so kind of richer, more in your face, almost intense. Love both, so I'm going to put them in as a tie. Next up then, we have Opium from Yves Saint Laurent, position officially number 2. The positions here not that important. So this is an incredibly rich, exotic, oriental style fragrances. Bourbon vanilla we've got in there. We've got anise, star anise or an aniseed-like licorice note. And a really, really fantastic, rich, opulent, sweet scent. This is the Eau de Parfum. There is a reissue Eau de Parfum that I think you can get now, but mine's a vintage from the mid-90s. And the name Opium is appropriate because it has this really intoxicating, almost narcotic kind of smell about it. Very, very rich, very sweet, tons of vanilla in there. There's also Szechuan pepper and cedar. It's really powerful, it's dark, it's intoxicating. It's kind of unisex smelling. I think women could wear this one. It might be a bit sweet for some people. It sort of smells, somehow it conjures up that image of an exotic drug den somewhere in the Orient. And that's not a good thing. I don't condone that. But this smell is absolutely fantastic. You can try today's Opium Eau de Toilette. It has many of the same notes. Just doesn't quite have the intensity of this lovely vintage bottle that I've got. And I believe you can still get a modern formula of the Eau de Parfum. YSL Opium, very overlooked in our community. And finally, top of the list for me this year, Egoist from Chanel. One of the greatest Chanel designer fragrances ever made for men. Opens up with some mandarin, but really it's one of the best sandalwood fragrances out there. Lovely, spicy, woody scent, focusing on a wonderful sandalwood note, mixed in with some vanilla. Really, really masculine, really classy, an old school vibe, but has that sweetness, spiciness. And if you like the note of sandalwood, this to me is one of the best sandalwood fragrances ever in the designer game. Really, really strong projection. My bottle is somewhat older than the modern one, which has a slightly different shaped bottle. So I guess it's a little bit vintage. It's not the first vintage or anything like that. If you're looking for something masculine, different from everything out there, sexy and seductive, Egoist from Chanel, first released in 1990. I think the perfumer on that one, Jacques Polge, highly recommended. And my number one fragrance from the designer fragrances for this year, 2018. Let me know what you thought of the list. Please comment down below. And as ever, remember, whatever you're doing in life, let's project.